Hi, I'm Terry Hitchcock. You are watching Harkins Theatres Behind the Screens. We have been involved in a summer of remakes and reboots and sequels. Well, now it's time for Quentin Tarantino's original film, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, where he takes a look back at 1969 in Hollywood. You got Bruce Lee, you've got the Manson murders, and the film features some of the biggest names around. Brad Pitt, Leonardo DiCaprio. Here's the bad news. We didn't get to talk to them in person. They were very limited with their time. However, Sony was nice enough to provide us a little glimpse of some of their comments as they sat down with the movie studio. Take a look.
I'm Rick Dalton.
That's your son?
No, it's my stunt double, Cliff Booth.
And I see this as a confluence of all your work to date in many ways. Maybe you could talk about that.
Well, there was a thing where, you know, I have a first aide named Bill Clark that has been with me since Jackie Brown. He came to the house to read the script, and I was really kind of curious what he was going to think about it. And he went out by my pool like these guys did and read it, and he came back in and he goes, "It's all of them." He goes, like, there's a bit of all your movies rolled into one, to one degree or another in this script. I look at this as my ninth movie, but then I think you can also look at it to some degree as like, okay, you can also look at it when it comes to a director's career where their films are focused, they didn't do a job, then maybe all the movies are one movie. They're all connected like boxcars on a train. And if that's the case, I think this is the climax. This seems like the climax of all those movies together. I'll do another movie, but that might be more of more epilogue-y, right? This seems like the big show-stopping climax.
My hands are registered as lethal weapons.
Not only is he forensic in sort of showing an audience a specific time period and a certain culture, mixed with fairy tale, mixed with sort of this, I don't know how to describe it, but this sort of tableau of memory that he has, all these things sort of fit in a very unique way that you don't see in modern filmmaking. And that's why it's so incredibly exciting to work on his movies, because there's this unexpected nature. Every day you're on set, you don't know what exactly is going to happen. And everyone feels incredibly energized and excited to be there, because there's the great unknown.
Who I got living next door to me?
I'm Sharon Tate. I'm in the movie.
I don't think anyone's ever walked into a Tarantino film and not been surprised, ever. And they're definitely going to get that with this film. It's not like anything else. It's not a remake, it's not a prequel sequel. It's its own thing entirely, but not only is it entirely original, it is so unique in a way that only Tarantino can pull off.
You in there?
Yeah, just not.
I was surprised how loose you are on the day. Mm-hmm. I mean, because the scenes are so specific and so well orchestrated, you would think they'd have to be planned out. I would think they'd have to be planned out to the end. And yet, still, when we get there on the day, there's a total looseness and freedom, like a trust in what you're going to capture that day within the confines of the...
Well, you know, that actually kind of is one of the benefits of, you know, having a career that spans more than 20 years.
In this town,
I can all change that day.
Hey, you're Rick Dalton. Don't you forget it.
Yeah, kind of a bummer we didn't get to talk to them in person. But if you want to see more with Margot, Leonardo DiCaprio, Brad Pitt, and of course, Quentin Tarantino, just click right here on the extended version.